learned about this, I was so frustrated because I waste years trying to do what a lot of black belts do today, and I can't believe. You know, it's like every time you want to get on your fours, the best way to do it is extending your legs, because then you have the power of your hip. If you try to come up this way, you see, even without somebody here, it's already hard. And I stopped playing with this, and that was a... I do for you, I do for the camera, come. The most common guard pass that was in jiu-jitsu for many years was this. People will get here, and they try very tight here, they would push the knee out of the way and get a cross side. Boom! That was everybody's move.
Still, so, right. Yeah, I still remember. We still do it.
Yeah. Still do it, right? So I start playing with the hip, and I start realizing that it depends on me to be here, to control me and to hold me down. So it's in reality, go again, do it again. Go tight. Yeah, please go. This one is brilliant. And I used to, I play with this, having fun.
You learned by luck.
Yeah, that was lucky, yeah. You see, there's a lot of things happening here. Look, when he passes, I extend. Can you go back from, please?
No.
And it works great with no gi and gi. If you guys look, come here. Look what I do now. When he passes, he thinks he's tight, everything's tight. Slowly look. I extend and I lock his arm. Look. Can you go back, please?
No.
Can you pull your hand out?
No.
Why? Rely on his principle. I'm sitting on his hand right now. I have his weight here and his arm is locked. So now I want to come up. What I do when I want to come up, I use the elbow. Ooh, across. And it got to a point that my training partners stopped going for this pass. Because you work with the gi, with no gi, and if you think every time you put the guy back in guard, he's here passing, put him back, he goes right there. Uh-huh. It got to a point that I would do just this, look.
But actually you don't need to wait until he's back, he passes, no, you just... No,